Hey, I'm Ben Boland.
And I'm Jonathan Strickland.
And today's question is, how do we decaffeinate coffee or tea?
Why would you want to do such a thing?
Not everybody likes the effects of caffeine.
Blasphemy.
But for those people, we have to have a process to extract caffeine from the plant products in which it occurs. There are four methods of extraction, which we primarily use.
Let's see, there's a brute force, coercion, subversion, and nuking from orbit because it's the only way to be sure.
There are four real versions used to extract caffeine. The first would be methylene chloride processing. Then there's ethyl acetate processing, not your Aunt Ethel.
No, I would hope not.
Then there's carbon dioxide processing and water processing. Methylene chloride is a solvent, and it's used to extract caffeine from not just coffee, but a lot of other materials. Mm. So first, you soften the material up in a water bath or by exposing it to steam. That process of extraction also extracts the oil and the flavor, all the good stuff.
So you would end up with a really weak cup of decaf coffee.
Yes, weak to the point of whackness. So what's the solution? It literally is a solution. You take this solution out of the extraction, you expose that to methylene chloride, and the methylene chloride removes the caffeine. You put the solution back with the material, and you've got your oils, you've got your flavorings, but what you don't have is
caffeine.
Ah, methylene chloride molecules and caffeine molecules, they bond. They tend to make a connection, you know?
Kind of like us.
Ethyl acetate is a similar process. In fact, it's exactly the same. If you picture a Mad Lib version of the methylene chloride process, just write in ethyl acetate.
So you should just rewind this video by about 45 seconds, watch it again, but just mentally replace those words.
That's what we would do. Ethyl acetate process products are the ones that you hear sold as naturally decaffeinated. It turns out that ethyl acetate is a chemical that naturally occurs in fruits.
Right, so this naturally occurring chemical is then applied to a very unnatural process, giving us natural decaffeination.
I'm sure there's an asterisk in there somewhere. The third way to decaffeinate a material is called carbon dioxide processing. You're essentially softening and pressure cooking the material with carbon dioxide. Once you have the high pressure and the high temperature, carbon dioxide reaches a supercritical state, meaning it functions both as a liquid and a gas.
The last time I was in a supercritical state, I was actually passing through Nebraska.
It becomes a solvent with its small nonpolar molecules attracting the small caffeine molecules. Since flavor molecules are larger, they remain intact in the material. Water extraction might be familiar to most people. The material is soaked in hot water, then that water is moved through a carbon filter. The carbon filter grabs the caffeine molecules and holds on to them. The water is then returned to the beans for reabsorption of the flavors and the oils.
If there's one thing I cannot stand about decaffeinated coffee, it's that it has no caffeine in it. But if there's two things I can't stand, it's when it's weak and just doesn't have the flavor.
And what we like to say around the office is if you lose the flavor,
you lose Strickland.
Caffeine's not removed completely by any of these methods. Under federal regulation in the United States, you can't call something decaffeinated unless it has less than 2.5% of the original caffeine.
And you can't call me at all unless I have at least 2.5% caffeine in my bloodstream.
So that's how decaffeination works. We hope you enjoyed watching this video. So if you want to write to us with a suggestion,
question,
drop us a line or send us an email.
Ooh, I actually have a question right now. So we live in the southeastern United States, and there's such a thing called unsweetened tea. Now, does that actually mean that they first sweeten the tea and then have a process to extract the sugar from the tea, thus making it unsweetened tea?
Are we still rolling?